Welcome to Faults Learn. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to insert, update, delete, and filter data in GridView using Entity Framework. Right-click on your project, then create an extra form. Next, delete Form 1 and change the main form to Extra Form. Right-click on your project, then add an ADO.NET Entity Data Model to your project. As you know, Entity Framework is an object relational mapper, which is a type of tool that simplifies mapping between objects in your software to the tables and columns of a relational database. Entity Framework is an open source ORM framework for ADO.NET, which is a part of .NET Framework. We will use the Northwind database to play the demo. If you don't have the Northwind database, you can download it from the faults-learn.com website. Click the Instant Layout Assistant link to design a simple UI that allows you to insert, update, delete and filter data in GridView. As you know, DevExpress WinForms component installation automatically adds the Layout Assistant extension to Visual Studio. Instant Layout Assistant is a design time helper that allows you to build a form, user control layout without searching for DevExpress controls in the Visual Studio toolbox. You should add a data source to your data layout control. As you know, Data Layout Control is a data-aware version of the Layout Control, which provides tools for connecting to a data source, choosing editors for displaying data, specifying bindings, etc. Drag a layout control from the Visual Toolbox to your Windows Forms application. Next, drag a grid control to your layout control. As you know, layout control is the main component of the DevExpress Layout Manager library. It allows you to arrange any controls within a form without them being overlapped and misaligned. You need to add a binding source to your grid control. The binding source component is designed to simplify the process of binding controls to an underlying data source. The binding source component acts as both a conduit and a data source for other controls to bind to. It provides an abstraction of your form's data connection while passing through commands to the underlying list of data. Additionally, you can add data directly to it, so that the component itself functions as a data source. You can bind the binding source component to both simple data sources, like a single property of an object or a basic collection like ArrayList, and complex data sources, like a database table. The binding source component acts as an intermediary that provides binding and currency management services. At design time or runtime, you can bind a binding source component to a complex data source by setting its data source and data member properties to the database and table, respectively. If you want to cancel the operation, you need to filter all objects that have changed status, then check the status of each object. Thank you for watching this video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel.